Previously on DanganRonpa.
She was found dead in the girls' locker room. There is absolutely no question about that. If there's any chance the murder took place somewhere else, let's see the proof.
But Chihiro's handbook should have only allowed her access to the girls' locker room.
Hold on a second. I agree with you, though. I think you're on the right track.
There's no way she could get in the boys' locker room, right? So...
why are you so sure she couldn't get in? There's still one other way she could have gained access.
It's kind of hard to believe, actually, what she's going for. She got something going on here, so let's account. Alright.
First of all, we know where Chihiro was headed.
Yes.
He was on his way to go exercise.
Yes, that's true.
So next we have to ask, why did he choose the specific tracksuit that he did?
What do you mean, the specific tracksuit?
I got it! He picked that tracksuit because it matched the one the culprit was wearing!
No.
So, what you're saying is, the killer was wearing the same blue tracksuit as him? My tracksuit is black!
I don't even have a tracksuit! Cause exercising sucks!
I have a white tracksuit, personally.
Does he?
I got it from the warehouse, if you must know.
Did any of that really help us get any closer to figuring out who the culprit is?
No way. Not a chance.
You heard him, right? What he just said without even realizing it?
She's right. What he said just now is really odd. How did he know something like that?
First of all, we know where Chihiro was headed. He was on his way to go exercise. So next we have to ask, why did he choose the specific tracksuit that he did?
What do you mean, the specific tracksuit?
I got it! He picked that tracksuit because it matched the one the culprit was wearing!
So, what you're saying is, the killer was wearing the same blue tracksuit as him? My tracksuit is black!
I don't even have a tracksuit! Cause exercising sucks!
I have a white tracksuit, personally.
No, that's not it. Shit. Yes, I see. So what are you saying is, I have absolutely no idea.
Shoot!
Just think about it one more time. There must be a conviction that somewhere...
First
shit, what?
All, we know where Chihiro was headed. He was on his way to go exercise. So next we have to ask, why did he choose the specific tracksuit that he did?
What do you mean, the specific tracksuit?
I got it! He picked that tracksuit because it matched the one the culprit was wearing!
So, what you're saying is, the killer was wearing the same blue tracksuit as him?
No, that's wrong!
KYOKO is onto something, I'm gone completely. I'm letting KYOKO carry
it. Hold on a second, Mondo. What did you just say?
Huh? What'd I say?
When Celeste testified a few minutes ago, she said...
I saw him stuffing a track jacket into a duffel bag, and then I assumed he had it off to exercise.
She never said anything about the jacket's color.
I am gone! KYOKO, carry it on, girl. I am gone. I am completely detached from this investigation. I do not understand anything that she was talking about at this point. But I'm fine. Like, she's 100,000 steps ahead of us. Jesus Christ.
So why did you say Chihiro's blue tracksuit?
Nobody ever mentioned the tracksuit was blue.
What are you? You just...
Hey, Celeste. What color was Chihiro's tracksuit?
As a matter of fact, it was... blue?
And before we began the trial, did you tell anyone that?
The only one I told about any of this was you.
Then, Mondo, how did you know what color Chihiro's tracksuit was?
But because I just... I'm sure he saw the clothes at some point in the investigation.
No, that can't be it.
Because the duffel bag and the tracksuit were both gone.
The bag and clothes were surely disposed of by the time we began our investigation.
I freaking love Kyoko. She is our girl for this case.
Then the only reason he could have known what color the tracksuit was is if he saw Cherry with it before he died. That's the only possibility.
Cherry? Are you talking about Chihiro?
I think she just classifies everybody as food at this point.
So, how about it? Did you see the tracksuit or didn't you?
Just by chance. I just happened to see it last night.
Last night?
He walked past me, and he was carrying the tracksuit in his hands.
No, that can't be it either. According to Celeste's testimony...
He wasn't carrying it in his hands, he was carrying it in a duffel bag. She stuffed the jacket into the bag in a hurry. It was almost like she was trying to hide it. And just like that, she was gone.
When Celeste noticed it, Chihiro made a point of making sure the jacket was completely in the bag. If you just ran into him briefly, you couldn't possibly have seen what color the tracksuit was.
Yeah.
It would appear you've dug your own grave.
Perhaps. But you handed him the shovel, didn't you? That's why you said what you did. Focus on the tracksuit and it'll be obvious who he met with? What a bunch of nonsense.
Ah, now I understand. It was all one big bluff, wasn't it?
Goddamn, Kyoko's brave.
Your true intention was to draw a slip of the tongue from the culprit. That's why you said you knew he did it. To put them on edge.
That's right. However, Mondo was my target all along. I had my suspicions about him from the very beginning.
Now, how the hell does she have a suspicion about it? When we were led around the circle, we were literally like a dog, taking a walk around the park, we were led around by Byakuya's ploy and the whole thing that he's doing. Jesus Christ, how the hell?
But why? What made you so suspicious?
How does she get suspicious of him?
That's a good question.
The way he talked, the way he was acting? The way he was acting? The way he talked?
There was a certain turning point that tipped me off. Maybe you didn't notice it, Mondo, but you tend to refer to men and women differently. You only call guys dude. For girls, it's chick. And after he was killed, you happened to refer to him as dude.
What? How did she even catch that? What the hell, Kyoko? God, it was right in front of us, it slipped away just like that. I didn't even think of it.
Once I picked up on that, it occurred to me that Mondo knew something we didn't.
Did you notice such a tiny detail?
Oh my god, Kyoko, best girl for investigations.
Are you a witch? She's a witch! You're positively frightful!
No, I'm not the frightful one. Not nearly as frightful as someone capable of murdering a friend.
Damn.
Mondo, was it really you? Did you really kill Chihiro?
I didn't kill anyone! You've been all over me, judging everything I say, putting words in my mouth. What gives you the right to treat me like a goddamn criminal?
Yeah, he would never do something like that. This is a false accusation.
It's true. My reasoning on that is pretty shaky.
That was fast.
Well, this does present us with a problem. It seems we are all out of leads.
My time has nearly come.
His voice changed.
That's what my little ghost friend is telling me.
Oh yeah, that reminds me. Kifumi, weren't you telling me you found some evidence?
Really? What kind of evidence?
Please be good. He looks clueless.
Actually, you know, now that I'm thinking about it here calmly, it might not be all that relevant.
God damn it! You for me, god damn it! You son of a bitch!
Jeez, does your confidence just get up and walk away? It's fine, man. Just tell us.
Please do. Please make sure it's relevant.
If you really insist, then... here it is.
Is that Chihiro's handbook?
Mm-hmm. What do you have there?
It is it? Is it Chihiro's handbook?
It happens to be an e-handbook.
I found it laying on the ground, so I scooped it up.
You found it on the ground, right? Chihiro's gotta be.
We know Chihiro's handbook was missing from the scene of the crime, right?
For a fact.
For a fact indeed. I was totally sure I'd found it.
Then it must hold some clue about the culprit, right?
Well, that's what I was hoping. But it's busted. It won't even turn on.
I imagine the culprit broke it to get rid of any evidence after the murder.
That's odd. I didn't think the handbooks were quite so fragile.
Yeah.
You're right. They're not. They're totally waterproof and shock resistant. It would take an awful lot to break one.
And yet, this one does appear to be broken, as is Leon's, sitting useless in the main hall. For all your confidence, that is a remarkably high failure rate.
Do you think there might be some kind of mystery in there somewhere?
Yes, there is.
How precisely did the handbooks get broken?
How did the handbook break? Hitting a weak point? Exploiting a bug? Hitting a weak point? It has to be. Not exploiting a bug. Maybe there's a bug. Maybe it's some kind of a bug you could exploit. Too bad for you, but those things have been debugged to hell and back. We can afford a recall. Guess we should just leave a possibility for a bug then. Embarrass myself in front of everyone. Shit. It has to be a weak point. It has to be a weak point. No way it could be hacked.
I got it! You already told us before that the handbook has one weak point, didn't you?
Yeah! You remember that? Sure, maybe I let that slip, but I never told anyone what the weak point actually was.
But if the handbook is supposed to never break, and two of them broke in quick succession, then...
Then we can only assume that someone's figured out its weakness. You know what the weakness is, right, Monokuma? So, what is it?
Huh? You're asking me?
Oh, don't tell me he doesn't know.
I think it's a necessary piece of information if you want this to be a fair trial.
But if I tell you, and someone else decides to copy it, that would be very not good.
Just tell us already! Why would we want to break our own handbooks?
Oh well, I have a weakness for pushy demands. But you're sure you won't follow their example? Then allow me to make a special announcement. The weak point of my cutting-edge e-handbook is... When it's exposed to high temperatures for too long, it will suffer a meltdown and totally break! I flippin' knew it!
You knew it?
Yeah, because I found the handbook laying on the floor of the sauna.
Oh!
The temperature in the sauna can reach over 200 degrees. Strange how you don't get burnt, huh?
Yeah.
It's because as your sweat evaporates, it creates a cooling layer of air around your skin. If the hot air of the sauna were somehow pushed directly onto your skin, you'd definitely get fried. That layer of air would get blown away. That's why you may feel a burning when you move around. So when you're in a sauna, make sure to keep nice and still.
Wow, interesting. I learned one new fact today.
Same here.
That is a mere trifling speck of knowledge.
Anyway, if you found the victim's handbook in the sauna, then the killer must have been purposely trying to raise its temperature in order to break it.
Meaning the culprit somehow knew its weakness.
But how'd they find out? Monokuma said he didn't tell anyone, right?
Then he probably would have taken Leon's handbook to the sauna?
Indeed. Quite the mystery.
What if they found out by accident?
Maybe.
What do you mean by accident?
I think Yoko is on something. Let me tell you exactly what I think. Mondo decided that he would take the handbook, right? He left his handbook back in his dorm. He went to go to the sauna. Maybe? No. Did he?
What if the killer took their own handbook into the sauna, not knowing its weakness, and it broke?
Oh. Then the broken handbook out in the lobby is actually Mondo's, and he took Leon's handbook for himself.
They'd realize it was broken, of course, and it wouldn't be hard to figure out why. And once they had Chihiro's handbook, they knew they had an easy way to dispose of it.
So the Manda would have Leon's handbook.
I won't say it's not possible, but who would have done something like that? I don't know of anyone who took their handbook into the sauna.
I know somebody that recently took their handbook into the sauna. Two people, actually.
I might know someone who did.
Two, exactly.
Whoa! Seriously?
I think the one who may have taken their handbook into the sauna was...
Oh, maybe it's Taka. Who might have brought their handbook into the sauna? He has to be the one who wore all the clothes into the sauna. It was... I know who it was. The person who took the handbook into the sauna with the full clothes on was Mandu, because Taka didn't have his clothes on.
Here's my answer. Mondo, your handbook got broken in the sauna, didn't it?
What? Why? Why do you keep accusing him?
Mondo and Taka had an endurance contest in the sauna not too long ago, remember?
Yep.
And for the contest, Mondo just so happened to keep his school uniform on.
Mm-hmm.
But little did he realize, he'd also left his handbook in one of his uniform pockets. And when it was all over, Mondo discovered that taking your handbook into the sauna could easily destroy it.
No, wait, hold on! You've got it all wrong! He would never kill-
Taka, your bro killed somebody.
I don't accept this! Show me the proof! The actual solid proof!
I mean, I don't want to believe it either, but... But I found something that proves it beyond a shadow of a doubt. Oh god. Make your argument. Shit. Broken e-handbook, Chihiro's e-handbook, card reader. Broken e-handbook, Chihiro's e-handbook, and card reader, okay.
Let's test Makoto's assertion. If what he says is correct, then Mondo, you broke your own handbook.
In other words, if Mondo's handbook is actually broken, then that proves that what Makoto said is right.
Well, my goddamn handbook works just fine.
Damn it, I missed it.
Look! Makoto was wrong after all! Mondo wouldn't hurt a fly!
I'm sure Mondo's handbook broke during the sauna showdown. If I can just prove that, then that will show that the handbook Mondo must actually... The handbook Mondo has must actually be...
Let's test Makoto's assertion. If what he says is correct, then Mondo, you broke your own handbook.
In other words, if Mondo's handbook is actually broken, then that proves that what Makoto said is right.
Well, my goddamn handbook works just fine.
Got him.
No, that's wrong. Mondo, the handbook you have right now, is it really yours?
No, it's not.
The fuck is that supposed to mean?
The broken handbook that was in the main hall, isn't that one actually yours?
What the heck are you talking about?
What I mean is, I think Mondo swapped his handbook out for one that actually works. I think he took Leon's handbook and replaced it with his own. After all, Monokuma said himself that Leon's handbook never should have broken.
That's right! The punishment it suffered wasn't nearly enough to destroy it.
Yep.
So then, the broken handbook in the main hall is actually Mondo's.
Mm-hmm.
Which would mean that the handbook Mondo has right now is actually Leon's. Yes?
Yep.
But doesn't that violate the school regulation that says loaning out your handbook is prohibited?
Except the dead cannot loan.
Well, here's how I look at it. There is a rule about loaning your handbook to another student. But if they're dead, they're not a student. It's kind of a gray area, I admit. But no worries. If anything, it just makes things more interesting.
Oh, Monokuma, you son of a bitch.
As such, I decree that exchanging handbooks with a corpse is not a violation of the rules.
Well, Mondo, if I'm wrong about this, you're welcome to say so. I'm happy to admit I made a mistake, but...
Son of a bitch! What's wrong, bro? Come on! Tell him he's wrong! You are wrong! You have to be wrong! Everything you just said is wrong! You made it all up!
Okay, Then why don't we look back on this case one more time, from the beginning? That way, everything will become clear, and we'll all see if I was right or wrong.
Oh, we're gonna piece it together, aren't we? Closing argument, begin. Okay, so what ended up happening here is Chihiro found, she was putting on a tracksuit. Celeste, Celeste actually looks nice in this picture. I have no idea why, maybe the thigh highs, I don't know. Looks attractive. But she found Chihiro. Chihiro was trying to, let's see, what do we got going on here? Trying to put stuff in a duffel bag. Yes, she saw that Chihiro had something in a duffel bag, which he quickly put away, and he ran off. Afterwards, Chihiro came up onto the boys' locker room. He came onto the boys' locker room, and he entered in. When he got in, he met up with somebody, put away stuff in a locker room, and as he was putting stuff away, let me see what happened here. As he was putting stuff away, the person that was with him started to pick up the weight, came up to Chihiro and killed Chihiro. This is where Chihiro got killed. Let me see if I can find anything that can represent that. Yes, okay. We got this, the bludgeon object. After that, no, hold on, wait. Oh, that's not it. We take it off, put the blood on the poster. So blood got on the poster and the carpet. Then the person who killed Chihiro dropped the dumbbell and Chihiro's body was left on there. Then in Act 3, somebody removed the carpet and moved it over to the girls' locker room, right? Let me check here, let me see if I can find something. Carried the body over, moved everything from one side to the other and swapped things around. So, what they had to do here is... take him to the girls' locker room, use the card reader to get in. No, hold on, no, that's not it, that's not it. I gotta piece it together here. What do we got going on here? So started cleaning this thing up. We're gonna work from the very bottom for now. So, brought over Chihiro's body, saw the bodies around, and then left Chihiro's body here. Okay, so that's what happened. Let's try to piece it all together now. Okay, so in Act 2, Chihiro died. In Act 3, the person swapped the mats around. Removed the poster here. Yes, and removed the poster, and then took Chihiro to the girls' room using the card reader from Junko and Saika. Used to get in there, and then opened the door. Then placed the body down and left the things as they are. Then, Yakuya came in and started setting stuff up here. First, he used this. Oh wait, no, I think I know what happened here. I think I understand what happened here. Then once they got in, they moved the posters around. Yes, they moved posters around and moved the carpet and then left Chihiro where he is at. Then, after that, Byakuya came in and strung up Chihiro on there. And let's see what else happened here. And wrote on the wall to make it to look like that was a little setup. During that time, use the card reader. It was at the sauna. In Act 5, Mondo came to the sauna, threw the card reader in there, and then closed the door. That's what happened. That has to be what happened. Okay, I think we're good here, ladies and gentlemen. Let's see if it goes.
The killer is you! First, let's take a look back to before the incident. Last night, Celeste saw Chihiro in the warehouse, correct?
Okay, looks like I'm getting... I think I got it right, actually.
At the time, she was apparently stuffing something into a duffel bag.
Oh, he. She noticed.
That something was a blue tracksuit. You can confirm this, right, Celeste?
Back two.
With bag in hand, Chihiro headed out. Even though it was officially nighttime.
Mm-hmm.
She made her way to the locker room, specifically the boys' locker room.
He.
But how could the victim, who is apparently a girl, access the boys' locker room?
No, I didn't lay out my reasoning right. I need to rearrange the events of the case. Okay, something here is missing. So... Oh, it gotta be this. It gotta be the card reader. It has to be the card reader.
Here's exactly what happened.
Okay.
With bag in hand, Chihiro headed out, even though it was officially nighttime.
Mm-hmm.
She made her way to the locker room, specifically the boys' locker room. But how could the victim, who was apparently a girl, access the boys' locker room?
I didn't lay out my reasoning right. I need to rearrange the event of the case. What? You've got to be shitting me. You've got to be shitting me. What did I miss out here? I missed something out here. I clearly missed something out. I missed something out here completely. It's none of this stuff, definitely not. I know that for sure. I know that for certain. So maybe it has to do with... Okay, it has to do with this. I think this is what it had to do. He was gained in, and then he entered the boys' locker room.
Here's exactly what happened.
Let's see, let's hope this is it.
With bag in hand, Chihiro headed out, even though it was officially nighttime. She made her way to the locker room, specifically the boys' locker room. But how could the victim, who was apparently a girl, access the boys' locker room?
There we go, good. Thank God.
Simple, because she was really a he.
It's kind of hard to tell which slides for the comic book they actually acquire of you, because there's no like written thing from there. You just kind of guess, plug him in, and try and error, which makes it even more stressful.
Which is why he was able to use his own e-handbook to gain entrance to the boys' locker room. Once inside, he met with someone there, and the person he met was the one who killed him. It seems likely that the killer grabbed the nearby dumbbell, approached the unsuspecting Chihiro, and attacked him. And that's where the bloodstains on the poster and carpeting in the boys' locker room came from. It was likely in the heat of the moment. The body was arranged, but the murder itself felt unplanned. Which is why the killer hurried to try and hide the act. First, pulling up the bloodstained carpet, then removing the bloody poster, and finally carrying the corpse into the girls' locker room. A girl's handbook was necessary to get into the locker room, of course. But this alone doesn't prove that the killer was necessarily a girl. After all, Sayaka and Junko's handbooks had been placed in the main hall. Using one of those, a boy could get into the girls' locker room without much problem.
Mm-hmm.
And that's exactly how the killer did it. With the carpet and the poster they brought with them, they got to work. They changed the layout of the boys' and girls' locker room in what you might call a crime scene switch. That could have been the end of things, but no.
No.
Hyakuya discovered the body and decided to intervene in the situation, making things even more complicated.
He fucked with us.
So, after stumbling on the crime scene, he went and grabbed the extension cord from the library, and then he got to work. He used the cord to string up Chihiro's lifeless body. Then, using the victim's own blood, he left a grisly message there at the scene of the crime. He wanted to create the illusion that Genocide Jack was responsible for the slaughter.
he's playing games and I hate him for it. So much.
And around the same time that Byakuya was putting together this facade, the killer, having already disposed of Chihiro's bag and other belongings, arrived at the sauna.
I'm actually looking, trying to look out the window because it's been about 2 hours of me recording this. Oh, it's stressful.
There, they plan to destroy the last piece of evidence. Chihiro's handbook.
I didn't lay out my reasoning right. I need to rearrange the events of the case. So this last thing, what do we need here? It's not the closing of the door. It's not this either. It was this. There we go. No. The door was not closed, right? Damn it, I can't save. Shit. It wasn't a dumbbell. No. It wasn't this whatsoever. No, whatever this is. No. It has to be this.
Here's exactly what happened.
Hopefully.
And around the same time that Byakuya was putting together this facade, the killer, having already disposed of Chihiro's bag and other belongings, arrived at the sauna. There, they planned to destroy the last piece of evidence. Chihiro's handbook.
Didn't they have my reasoning right? I need to rearrange the events of the case.
And just as the killer expected, the steamy sauna was enough to ruin the electronic gadget.
Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and take a little break right here. I know this is not the same answer that I chose before. I had to redo the full thing in order to get back to this. But here's my thought process. The white handbook on the left and the blue and black and blue handbook on the middle do not match in no freaking color. They do not match in no color, and that is bullshit. This is the reason why I couldn't get the last piece of evidence, because honestly, the one on the very left looks like a piece of paper with a school crest on it. That's what it looks like. It matches nowhere close to what the one in the middle, the black one with the blue, looks like whatsoever. Why would the game design be like that? That is the one reason why I messed up, and I think it's BS. But you know what? Finally, through the process of everything, I finally did it. Jesus Christ. I've been recording this for over 2 hours now, and just sitting here planted and just having my full focus and attention onto this is so frustrating, because it drains your attention through it, and I want to succeed, but I have to redo this BS steps over and over sometimes, because it's there, but the design of it messed me up. It's stressful. One of the most stressful case-based games ever. Fun, but really stressful.
Somehow, the killer knew that the handbook couldn't stand up to the heat of the sauna. And the reason they knew that is because the sauna had already wrecked their own handbook. And that's how it all played out. Isn't that right, Mondo Iwata?
That is quite a picture of him. Holy shit. We got it, thank God.
Wait. No. This can't be right.
I think we got like one last step left, but we're close to getting this done.
Where's your evidence? Yeah. Where's your evidence? You need evidence. You need proof. Without any proof, you can't pin any of this on him.
Evidence that Mondo is a killer. That already revealed itself early in the trial. If I can somehow show where Mondo's handbook is right now. Once I do that, everything will become clear. A new element is added to the bullet time battles. Would you like to hear more? Yes. Please, I just finished this. This is so grueling. 2 hours of this.
Next time on DanganRonpa.
Wait! Hold on!
No waiting! No holding on! Time for the moment we've all been waiting for. Grab your lever and give it a yank! Who will you elect as the Blackened this time around? Will you make the right choice or the dreadfully wrong one? What's it gonna be? What's it gonna be?
Hey guys, how's it going? My name is Samrio. Welcome to Hello, what have we got here? Hello, ladies. How's it going?
breasts as a treasure yet.
I kind of want to say you could dress better.